The Bleach key visual has finally been lifted or announced, and we finally see it in all of its glory of what the anime is going to be looking like. And before I show you that, it is going to be exciting because Anime Japan, or Anime Expo, sorry, is going to be around the corner on the 2nd of July, or if you live in the UK, it's going to be the 3rd of July, depending on time zones. We're going to be getting a confirmed preview animated trailer at the event, along with many other things that we spoke about previously in other videos. So it is fully confirmed that we are going to be seeing some form of video. Now, I was hoping that we were going to get screenshots of this week of Weekly Shonen Jump magazine, but we don't. We just get the key visual, and I will say I am pleasantly surprised. Now, of course, there will be a higher def version in the future because obviously this is magazine quality and it's degraded a little bit in quality, so take it as you will. But on your screen right now, you will see the key visual for Bleach. And just as I've seen from the character sheets, they are keeping the 3-4 shadowy style. It looks clean, it looks crisp. Bambietta was the first character that stuck out to me because she looks great. Her personality really drives through the key visual, and I'm excited. Now, I am surprised that they didn't use Ichigo for the key visual. That was a surprise. I do believe there will probably be more than one, I think. Don't ask me why, I just have a feeling, because I just don't see this key visual being the one to be promoting it on maybe streaming platforms or elsewhere. So I think that this is maybe going to be one of two. That's just from my guess. But again, I love the color palette and the shadowing of this whole key visual in general, especially with the Quincy's. Now, before I talk about that, censorship. Seems like Siphon is keeping the side titty, which I'm very happy about. I love the swords. The sword looks great. It looks, again, like Akadama Drive, as we have got a team from Akadama Drive working on Bleach, as well as old Bleach staff as well. So again, comparing it to the key visual, the pre-animated trailer that we had before, it looks nothing like that. I mean, there's some aspects that do granted, but these models are a lot more cleaner. They're a lot more designed for the anime rather than the pre-animated trailer that was strictly towards manga style, or basically one for one trace and cut from the manga itself with color obviously added on. So you can see Shinji's hair just isn't as thick lined as it was in the pre-animated trailer, and Byakuya looks a lot nicer. Again, loving the line art, loving the shadowing specifically. I was really interested to see how these dark shadows would work, and they really do. Again, Siphon stands out to me, as she should. But also, again, Bambietta stands out to me as well. And I love, like, the glaring lights off the hats itself. And again, that blue, light blue, and dark shadowing on the clothes as well. Again, we are only seeing a few of the Storm Riders in comparison, mainly so the ones at the start of the series. But again, you have to show some love to, like, you know, Jerome and Driscoll and X, Y, and Z, you know, characters that didn't have a time to shine, because this will probably be their only time to shine. Unless Kubo adds in those extra scenes, extra contents in the Thousand Blood War itself, which would be nice. Granted, I know it kind of takes away a little bit of the pacing, but hopefully a little bit of a flashback in between the conversation between Kenpachi and Yuwatch would have been nice in and of itself. But then again, would that take away from seeing Kenpachi and then seeing him get held by his neck? So again, yeah, there's a lot to talk about, but again, I'm just loving these designs, and I really want to see what you guys think as a whole. The text at the bottom does say that we are going to be getting pre-screenings of episode 1 and episode 2. Now, you can take this as a 50-50, and I'll explain why shortly after, because it says that these episodes are going to be screened on September the 11th, only for event members only, so you have to pay to go see these episodes. Again, I unfortunately won't be able to attend as much as I would like to, but this could either be a good thing or it could be a bad thing. I have heard of pre-events previously in the past where, you know, a production committee will essentially force or rush a team to get these episodes done so they can market it and do these type of events, and usually the pre-screening event doesn't look as good as the final event, which will be on screen on TV, or even the Blu-rays for that matter. But again, we don't know if that is really going to be the case for Bleach's situation. Is episode 1 done? As far as I know, it's not. But if it is, it will probably be finished very shortly, because as far as I know, they're still on like the Genga stage and or the key animation stage. So, or maybe final touch-ups. We know that they're doing the voice acting, so I imagine a lot of it is touch-ups and maybe in-betweens or extra little bits and pieces that they want to refine. That's my assumption. So I have no problem with episode 1. I have no information on episode 2 to really comment whether that's going to be done or not, or whether it's going to be done in time. So again, it's really hit and miss. Is this a good thing that it's being pre-screened? Is it a sign of good production? Honestly, I wish I could tell you it's hit and miss. But again, people are going to be able to see that, and hopefully we should see some responses from people on Twitter or even online to say or validate if it's going to be good or not. I will say, from what I know, storyboards and from what I've seen of episode 1, looks gas. Episode 1, I don't know the song, but it's going to be gas, supposedly, so I'm excited. But yeah, this is the Bleach key visual, and I'm excited. Toshiro, Soifan, Shinji. So Shinji looks surprisingly clean, and the formation of characters is great too. See Mayuri, Gemryu Usai, it just looks great, but to see the Sternritters too. I'm also looking at Bambiette, I can't stop at her. Like, her personality just shines. Basby just has swagger, Harshwold looking as Harshwold does, and Yuabak standing there. I mean, Weisel... I don't know why Weisel's there out of all of them. And look at Asgin, bro. Asgin looks clean as well. And then you obviously have the characters at the back, such as Asnot. And I forgot his name. You at the back. You over there. What is your name? It took me ages. Kurge. There you go. Kurge at the back. Again, looking nice as well. The rest of them, again, they're kind of off-screen characters or characters you're not going to see until later on in the series. So again, I'm interested in the design choice. But I can't wait to see the HD version of this image as a whole. So there you go, we have the Bleach key visual, we have a PV in a few days time, and I am excited to see how everything's gonna look. The lighting effects, the character designs, everything looks perfect so far. Again, very optimistic. As I said in streams before, character designs are looking great for Ichigo and the others, so I have no shadow of a doubt. And again, take this screenshot as a pinch of salt, because this is degraded quality for the magazine. I'm sure you're going to see a more HD photo in a few days time after the event. But with that being said, please like, comment and subscribe to be kept up to date with all the news that I'm going to be providing with you. It is very early in the morning, so please hit that subscribe as compensation. With that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.